Welcome to BCH Technologies. Today we are going to remove the print head from an Epson WP-4540 for a deep cleaning. This printer belongs to Greensboro Keller William Real Estate Company and has been sitting in a storage for years. After few head cleanings, the magenta and black were still clogged. We try to wet the print head with cleaning liquid, but the clog persists. So we decided to take the print head out for a deep cleaning. Warning, this procedure should be done by professionals. Do not try this at home. When you open the cartridge door, the printer will raise a white lock to prevent the cartridge from moving freely. Therefore, you need to disconnect the power before the lock is in place. Open the door and disconnect the power immediately. Make sure the cartridge assembly can move freely. I know some people are very skillful working at limited spaces, for example, build a warship in a bottle. If you want to remove print head out without taking apart the printer, you can follow those steps. 1. Take off this cover. Step 2. Remove two screws holding the electronic ribbons and ink supply line. Lift up and remove the ink tubes and electronic ribbons, then the four screws holding the print head will be exposed. Step 3. Take off those four screws and the print head can be detached from printer body. For hopeless folks like us, let's get started. You will need a large Phillips screwdriver for the case and small Phillips screwdriver for the printhead. Optional picking tools and magnetizer/demagnetizer will be helpful too. Find a hole near the white knob on the left corner, press in with your finger and pop up the top cover. Do the same to the right side. On the front, you have three screws to be removed. You have two wires, a black ground wire and a red black door trigger wire. Also, there is an electronic ribbon to be disconnected. Take a picture so you can remember how to put them back. Turn to the back of the printer, remove two top screws. Remove two screws from top and bottom of the back wire plate. Take a picture of the wire bundles, so you can remember the sequence. Also make a checklist, from the top to bottom, pull out four white-gray, three gray, three black, two red and black wire bundles, then unscrew one black ground wire. Now turn to the front and disconnect the red black door trigger wire and a black ground wire. Now the top unit can be separated from the rest of the printer. Turn to the back of the printer and remove the four screws holding the box cover. Turn to the front, remove two screws on the front cartridge box and one screw at top right. Then remove the cartridge door. Remove these two screws still holding the box cover and then you can remove the box. Sweet victory. Now we remove these two screws and move on to the printhead. Remove four more screws and we can take the print head out. We gave it a hot water shower. You can see the cyan and black is coming out okay, but the middle of magenta and yellow are still clogged. We broke a needle to make a poor man's declogging tool to flush the printhead. Time for a nice hot steam bath. Notice the black color is completely unclogged. More and more magenta is unclogged. Put the print head in a bowl and pour in cleaning solutions. Do not submerge the electric sockets. You need to keep them as dry as possible. Otherwise, an electrical short circuit can permanently damage the printhead. An ultrasonic cleaner can further loosen and remove clogs caused by solid particles, like dried pigment ink. Make sure you select a cleaner that has a plastic basket. Do not put printhead on steel bottom. Again, do not submerge the printhead's electric socket. If your cleaner requires a minimal liquid level, adjust the position of the basket and keep the electronic parts dry. One more steam bath and we are ready to put everything back. I hope you enjoy this video. Visit us on www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at our office at Greensboro, North Carolina. Happy printing. See you next refill. Cheers.